hey, one more video for you. This one is a little serious about evictions. As a landlord myself, I've been usually the person in charge of filing these evictions, getting the non-paying renters out. That's been my half of it. But I always look for things that the renters could do to try to keep them in that apartment no matter what it took. And I want to cover some important things for if you got an eviction notice or you're afraid that you might. The most important things. Now, it would say, it's going to be more structured than this, but it would say something like this: notice to quit, which basically means get out. But you're also going to, especially nowadays, you're going to look for the helpful information that's also required, that we are required to let you know. Look for phone numbers, websites, look for dates, court dates. When you get that, here's what to do. Number one, don't just move out. It's scary, you've never been in this situation before, and you're just like, now I'm gonna have to be an evicted person. I'm moving out. Don't just do that. Call the landlord, email them, however you best communicate. Number three, take care of your spot. Look around, make sure your place is on the outside, on the inside, that you're keeping that place up. If there's an inspection of patios, porches, whatever, and you have junk that's not allowed out there, if you have noise complaints from your neighbors that the office has taken, these things are not protected eviction criteria. So you can still be evicted for things that are a violation of the lease that are not non-payment. Make sure you're not doing any of those. Number four, go to the court date. If you're not at a court date for any kind of eviction, it's so easy for the judge to say this person must not care, and he'll authorize the sheriff to go and change your locks by filing a writ of possession. Go to that court date. Judges will hear your situation, hear that you're willing to try to, no matter how long it takes, work something out. This is all unprecedented for everyone, so state your willingness to cooperate. Do your best not to be nasty and mean, because remember, any communication going forward that you do with your landlord, the manager, those things all might come up in court later. And you'd like those all to be just to the point. Hey, I'm calling to let you know I would like to stay in. Not sure how I'm gonna do it. I'm going to the court date. Let me know if there's anything I can do other than pay rent right now, because I can't. Would you be willing to accept any money that's not the full amount? Usually not, but you can offer that. Number one, in review, don't just move out. Number two, communicate with that landlord. Look for any other phone numbers and websites you can use for resources to possibly even get assistance. Google that. Number three, take care of your spot. Don't give any other reasons for you to be evicted on. The last thing is go to the court date. When there is a court date, when it gets to a form that actually has a court date on there, a summons, go to that thing. Find out where it is, when it is, how to get there, what you do. Thanks for watching. Good luck.